Good day everyone, I'm teacher Jonathan and welcome to my channel, the Kuya Babsi channel. In today's video, we'll be discussing about linear inequalities. So this lesson is for grade 8 students. Okay, so this is a mathematics 8 lesson. So without further ado, let's start it now. Alright, graded students, our lesson for today is all about linear inequalities. Okay, so for this topic, our objectives is to illustrate a linear inequality in two variables, differentiate a linear equation in two variables from a linear inequality in two variables, and last is graph linear inequality in two variables. Okay, so first, let's compare linear equations versus linear inequality. Ano ba ang pagkakaiba ng dalawang ito? So, tingnan natin. It says here that linear equation defined as an algebraic expression whose graph is a straight line and whose variable has degree of 1. And we also know that a linear equation can be written in the standard form of ax plus by is equal to c, where a, b, c are real numbers and a and b are not both 0. So, ito yung pinag-aralan natin last quarter, di ba? It's all about linear equation, so linear, ang kanyang graph is a straight line, and the highest degree is degree 1. So ito yung standard form niya, ax plus by equals to c. While here in linear inequality, says here that it defines as a mathematical statement involving a linear expression that uses any of the inequality symbols like greater than, less than, greater than and equal, less than and equal, instead of equality symbol. It may have one or more variables, each of which is of degree of 1. Right? Para mas maintindihan nyo, let's have an example. Kung sa linear equation, mayroon tayong example na y is equal to 3x plus b, 3x plus 5, should I say, pagdating kay linear inequality, hindi na po equal ang gagamitin. So, gaya nito, y is greater than 3x plus 5, y is less than 3x plus 5, y is greater than and equal to 3x plus 5, y is less than and equal to 3x and 5. As you can see, apat ang possible na pwedeng pagpilian para maging linear inequality. Unlike kay linear equation, so yun, equality symbol lang pong ginagamit. So isa yun sa pagkakaiba nilang dalawa. Ano pang pagkakaiba nila? When it comes to graph, so, kapag ginagraph natin yung linear equation, meron tayong tinatawag na ascending. Meron din tayong tinatawag na descending. Okay. So, while here in linear inequality, ma-encounter natin ito, yung tinatawag na strict inequality. Okay, so ganyan yung itsura ng example ng strict inequality kapag ginraph ko siya. And another one is yung non-strict inequality. So, nakikita niyo yung pagkakaiba ng graph ng linear equation sa linear inequality. As you can see, dito, straight line lang siya. While here, meron siyang parang portion, shaded portion o shaded part. Tapos magkaiba ito. As you can see, tignan niyo rin dito, may shaded portion din. So, yan yung pagkakaiba nila when it comes to graph. So, ang tanong, sir, ano ba yung strict inequality at non-strict inequality. Ano bang pagkakaiba niyan? Check natin. Ano bang pagkakaiba ng dalawang yan? So, sa strict inequality, it is an inequality that uses either of the symbols greater than or less than. Example, y is greater than 3x plus 5 or y is less than x minus 3. Its solution set does not include the boundary line of its graph and it uses a dotted line. Okay, so, yun yung meron kay strict inequality. While here in non-strict inequality, okay, so dito pala, ito yung itsura ng graph niya, dotted line yung bow. Yung po yung dotted line. While here in non-strict inequality, it's an inequality that uses either of the symbols greater than and equal or less than and equal. So example niya is y greater than or equal to 2x plus 1 and y is less than or equal to x minus 4. Its solution set does includes the boundary line of its graph and it uses a solid line. Okay, so gumagamit daw siya ng solid line. So pansinin nyo, pagdating dito sa mathematical equation niya or mathematical form niya, itong strict inequality, ito lang po, greater than or less than. So kapag gumamit ka ng ganito, greater than and equal at less than equal, hindi na po siya strict inequality. That is non-strict inequality. Sabi pa rito, pagdating naman sa boundary line, yung solution set daw, hindi included. Okay, so mamaya ma-encounter nyo, anong ibig sabihin niya, included or not included ang solution set sa boundary line. Okay, so, para mas maintindihan natin, let's continue. How to graph a linear inequality? Okay, let's have an example number one. Graph the linear inequality y greater than 2x plus 1. Okay. So, titignan natin ano yung given. Y is greater than 2x plus 1. Anong klaseng inequality yan? Yes, very good. That is strict inequality kasi gumamit siya ng greater than. Okay. Ano bang first step natin? Okay, sa solution, to draw a boundary line, change the inequality symbol to an equality sign and draw the line on the Cartesian plane. In this case, the y greater than 2x plus 1 will become y is equal to 2x plus 1. Okay, so ibig sabihin lang yan, bago tayo mag-graph dito sa Cartesian plane, kumbaga, mag-ano muna siya, mag-evolve, okay, mag-change ng itsura from greater than or inequality symbol to equality sign. So, babaguhin siya, babalik ka sa pagiging isang linear equation niya. Pansamantala lamang po yan para magamit natin siya for graphing. Okay, since nagpalit na tayo, anong gagawin nating step? Okay, so back to linear equation. Siyempre, para mag-graph mo, kailangan mong kunin yung kanyang slope at ang kanyang y-intercept. So, in this case, we have y is equal to 2x plus 1 at ang slope niya is 2 over 1. Ang kanyang y-intercept, b is equal to 1. Okay, so, paano mag-graph niyan? Unang-una, gagamitin natin si y-intercept. So, saan yan? Saan ang coordinates ng y-intercept? Positive 1. Yun. So, yun yung y-intercept natin, yung unang coordinate natin. Next, from that point, gagamitin natin si slope. 2 over 1. Ibig sabihin, dalawang beses kang tataas, aangat at isang beses pa kanan since positive sila pareho. So, dito, 1, 2, hinto kay 3, tapos isang beses papunta rito sa kanan. So, malamang dito ka hinto. And then, ano na pwede natin gawin? Pwede na tayong gumawa ng boundary line. We just need to connect the two points. Okay, so yan yung tinatawag na boundary line. In this case, ang boundary line niya ay dotted line. Bakit? Kasi strict inequality po ang ating ginagraph. Okay, anong next step? Choose any test point or coordinate that doesn't lie on the boundary line and substitute its coordinate into the inequality. Pipili daw tayo ng isang test point. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng test point, sir? Ibig sabihin, pipili ka lang ng kahit anong coordinates yan. Pwedeng dito, pwedeng dito, pwedeng dito, pwedeng dito, kahit saan actually. Pero para makita lang natin kung yan ba ay part ng solution set ng given. Okay, let us say ito yung napili natin. Anong coordinates yan? Negative 3, 3. Okay, yan ang gagamitin natin for test point na tinatawag. Continue natin. So, ang gagawin natin, kopyahin natin yung original. So, wala na si linear equation na. Bumalik na tayo dun sa original given. Yan. Anong gagawin natin kay negative 3 and 3? Isasubstitute po natin yung value ng x and y gamit ang coordinates na yan. Okay, yan po. Si y naging 3. Bring down natin si greater than. Just copy 2. And substitute x by negative 3. And bring down plus 1. After the substitution, syempre, execute lang natin yan. Yan po. Bring down 3, bring down greater than, and 2 times negative 3 is negative 6. And then bring down positive 1 again. Then bring down 3, bring down again, and what is negative 6 plus 1? Of course, that is negative 5. Now let's analyze this one. Is this true or false? 3 is greater than negative 5. Totoo ba na mas malaki ang 3 kaysa kay negative 5? Yes, that's true. Since nag-true, yung test point natin na negative 3 and 3, ang ibig sabihin lang po niyan, itong portion na ito, okay, sabi niya dito, negative 3 and 3 is one of the solution set of y greater than 2x plus 1. Okay, so since kasama siya sa solution set, ibig sabihin yung portion na to, yung kanyang solution set. Okay, so yan, nakuha na natin yan. Actually, ito na yung sagot eh. Pero, just to satisfy yung mga ibang questions, just in case, hindi ako pumili rito. Hindi yan ang test point na pinili ko. Let us say, ito, yung coordinates na yan, 2, negative 4. Sa tingin nyo, magiging true ba or false? Okay, let's try. Same process, just copy the given y greater than 2x plus 1, then substitute the given coordinate, which is 2 and negative 4. The value for y is negative 4, bring down greater than, just copy 2 and substitute the value of x, which is 2, and then bring down 1. Just continue. Copy, negative 4 and greater than, what is 2 times 2, that is positive 4, and then bring down 1. Okay, let's compare. Negative 4 greater than, just copy, what is 4 plus 1, that is 5. Now, i-analyze natin yan. Negative 4 is greater than 5. Mas malaki ba ang negative 4 sa 5? Of course, that's not true. That is false. Okay, ibig sabihin yan, 2 and negative 4 is not part of the solution set of y greater than 2x plus 1. So, kapag ganyan, nag-false po, wala siyang karapatan na gawing shaded portion yan. So, ibig sabihin, hindi siya kabilang sa solution set ng given na y greater than 2x plus 1. Unlike kanina, true siya, kaya ibig sabihin, siya yung isi-shaded part mo. Ngayon, sinasabi ko kanina, kapag dotted line, hindi daw pwedeng kabilang maging solution set ng isang strict inequality. Okay, tignan natin kung talagang totoo yun. Well, let us say, okay, gumamit tayo ng isang one of the points of the boundary line. Ito yung coordinate na negative 2 and negative 3. Check na nga natin kung magiging true or false yan. Kung sabi kasi kanina, magiging false daw. Okay, let us see. Same process. Y greater than 2x plus 1, substitute negative 2 and negative 3 for x and y. So, yun. Sinubstitute ko siya. Then, execute natin. Bring down negative 3, bring down greater than, what is 2 times negative 2, that is negative 4, and then bring down positive 1. Bring down negative 3, bring down greater than, and then what is negative 4 plus 1, that is negative 3. Okay, analyze natin. Negative 3 is greater than negative 3. Ito kaya yan, mas malaki ang negative 3 kay negative 3. That is false. Okay, since nag-false yan, napatunayan po natin na hindi pala pwedeng include ang any point sa boundary line sa solution set ng isang strict inequality. Okay, so ang final answer natin, oh, yan po. Solution set does not include the boundary line of its graph. Okay, so final answer natin, ganito lang ang graph nitong y is greater than 2x plus 1. Yan po. Okay, so let's have another example. So graph the linear inequality y is less than or equal to 3/4x minus 5. Anong klaseng inequality po ang ating i-graph? Isa po siyang non-strict inequality. Okay? So, solution? Okay, so, pareho po ang process. Unang process po natin, step is to change the given inequality to linear equation. So, yun. Pinalitan lang natin ito. Ginawa lang natin equal symbol. Okay? And then, what's next? Of course, prepare natin si Cartesian plane para may graph na natin yan. And then, kukunin po natin na kanilang slope at y-intercept. In this case, the slope of the given equation is 3/4 at ang kanyang y-intercept is negative 5. Anong gagawin natin unang-una? Paano natin i-graph yan? Yung linear equation na yan? So, syempre, unahin natin si y-intercept, negative 5. Saan bang negative 5 sa y-axis? Ayun. Negative 5. Starting from negative 5, syempre, magka-count tayo gamit ang slope. 3 pataas at 4 pakanan. Parang kanta yun, 3 pataas. 1, 2, 3. Hinto ka negative 4 and then apat daw pakanan. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, malamang sa malamang, dyan po yung okay, coordinate natin. Then, ipoconnect natin yan. Remember that two points determine a line. Okay, gagawa tayo ng isang boundary line. At anong itsura ng boundary line ng isang non-strict inequality? Nabanggit natin kanina, isa siyang solid line. Okay? Nakagawa na tayo. So, tapos na nating ma-graph yung solid line or boundary line ng isang non-strict inequality. So, anong next step natin? Tama, choose a test point. Ito na yung trial and error. Subukan natin kung alin dyan ang magiging true or false. So, it's either this side or this side. Okay, so suggestion ko lang po, just in case na gumagamit tayo ng fraction na ano, na slope, okay, I suggest kapag ganyan din, pwede natin gamitin test point yung point of origin, which is 0, 0, para mas mabilis ang computation. Okay, gamit ang y is less than and equal to 3/4 x minus 5, substitute lang natin si 0, 0 kay x and y. Ayan po. Sinubstitute lang natin. Then, execute natin. Okay, madali na lang po yan. Okay, napansin nyo? Bring down 3/4 times 0, 0. Bring down negative 5. What is 0 minus 5? Negative 5. Ngayon, analyze natin. Is 0 is less than or equal to negative 5? Mas mababa siya or equal? That is false. Remember that 0 is greater than any negative numbers or integers. Okay. Hindi rin sila equal. Magkaiba naman silang integers. So false. Ibig sabihin, itong portion na ito, hindi mo siya pwedeng i-shade. Ibig sabihin, hindi siya kabilang sa solution set ng isang given na non-strict inequality na ito. Itong y is less than or equal to 3x, 3 over x, 3/4 x minus 5. Okay, so saan tayo pwede? Doon tayo sa kabilang dako. Subukan natin itong sa kabilang, ano, kabilang side naman. So, anong coordinate yan? That is 4, negative 4. Okay, gamitin natin yan as a test point. Okay, same process, substitute the value of x and y. Okay, good. Value of y is negative 4, value of x is 4. And then, execute natin, 3, 4 times 4. That is positive 3. Paano nakuha yan, sir? So, bring down lang itong dalawang to. 3 times 4, 12. Divided by 4, 3. O kaya, cancel mo lang yan. 4 na yan, matitira si 3. And then, bring down negative 5. So, what's next? Then po. Just copy this 2. And then, 3 minus 5 is negative 2. Ngayon, i-analyze natin. Negative 4 is less than or equal to negative 2. True or false? Mas mababa ba ang negative 4? Kay negative 2? Yes. That is true. So, dahil true yan, of course, isi-shade natin yung portion na yan. Ano ibig sabihin niyan kapag na-shade natin? That is automatically included sa kanyang solution set. Ngayon, to satisfy mga question nyo, eh paano sir, kung ang pinili ko is one of the coordinates that passes through the boundary line. Okay, so paano kung dito ako pumili ng test point? Magiging true kaya or false? Kasi kanina, naging false ta strict inequality dito kaya sa non-strict. Try natin. We have the coordinate 4 and negative 2. Same process. Substitute the value of x and y, which is 4 and negative 2. Okay. And then, execute natin. Bring down negative 2, bring down the equality sign or symbol. And then, what's 3, 4 times 4? That is 3. And then bring down negative 5. Execute natin. Bring down negative 2 and bring down the symbol. What is 3 minus 5? Negative 2. Ang tanong, negative 2 is less than or equal to negative 2. True or false? That is true. They are equal. So, that is true. Ibig sabihin yan, itong boundary line natin, okay, its solution set does include the boundary line of its graph. So, kabilang daw siya. So, ang solution set pala ng y is equal to less than or equal to 3/4 x minus 5. Okay, so yan po. Yung shaded portion including the boundary line. So, mas malawak ang kanyang sakop compare sa strict inequality. Okay, so ano bang natutunan nyo? Okay, ito po yun, no? Ito po yung binigay ko rin kanina. Natutunan natin na sa pagdating sa strict inequality, gumagamit siya ng, yan, less than or greater than. Yung solution set, hindi kabilang. At gumagamit ng dotted line. Dito naman, gumagamit na, yon, yung symbol na at most or at least na tinatawag ko minsan. Solution set includes the boundary line. Gumagamit siya ng solid line. Alright. So, sana may natutunan na kayo rito. Try natin sagutin itong mga question na to. True or false lang naman to. Number one. Okay, what is the answer number one? Linear inequality is a mathematical statement involving a linear expression that uses any point of inequality symbols greater than, less than, at least, at most instead of equality symbol. True or false? That is true. Okay, number two. Strict inequality is an inequality that uses either of the symbols greater than or less than. That is true again. The solution set of strict inequality thus includes the boundary line of its graph. Of course, that is false. Non-strict inequality is an inequality that uses either of the symbols, okay, greater than or equal or less than or equal. That is true. Strict inequality uses a solid line of its graph. That is false. Okay. Ginagamit ng strict inequality ay dotted line. Number 6. Okay. 3/4 is a solution set of y is greater than x plus 1. Kasama ba siya sa solution set nito? Let's check. Let's just substitute. Ito yung solution po. Okay, yung process na ginagamit natin, substitute x and y. Okay, and then, yun. 3 plus 1 is 4. Is 4 greater than 4? False. Ibig sabihin, ang sagot sa number 6, false din. Ito yung solution niya. Number 7, y is greater than or equal to 3x plus 5 is an example of non-strict inequality. True or false? That is true. Anong pakalatandaan yun po? Greater than or equal. Number 8, 0, 0 is a solution set of y less than 2/3 x plus 1. Paano natin malalaman? Siyempre, test point yan. Okay, substitute natin si 0, 0 sa x and y. Yan po. And then, execute lang natin. 2/3 times 0. That is 0. 0 plus 1, that is 1. 0 less than 1, that is true. So, ibig sabihin, ang sagot sa number 8 is true. Number 9, strict inequality uses a dotted line of its graph. True or false? That is true. Okay, dito tayo sa number 10. The graph of y is less than or equal to 2x minus 4 is ganito daw. So, kaya yan? Let's check. Okay, suppose gagamit tayo ng test point na 2, 0. Okay, so you know yung nasa kanyang boundary line, 2, 0. Nga natin. Okay, so substitute 0 and 2. 2 times 2 is 4, and then bring down the rest. And then 4 minus 4 is 0. Okay, 0 is less than or equal to 0. Nag-true ba? Okay, nag-true siya, no? So okay na tong kanyang boundary line. So, ang problema lang natin dito, kung magtutrue ba dyan. Subukan natin si 3 and negative 3. Okay. So, one of the coordinates dito sa portion na ito, itong shaded part. Substitute, negative 3 for y and positive 3 for x. And then, 2 times 3 is 6. Ayun. And then, bring down lang yung iba. What is 6 minus 4? That is 2. And then let's compare. Negative 3 or is less than or equal to positive 2. That is true again. So, naging true sila pareho dito sa shaded part at sa boundary line. Ibig sabihin, yung sagot dito sa number 10 is true. Alright, so there you have it. That's all for today. Thank you, grade 8 students. I hope you learned something from me today. So, don't forget to like and share, subscribe, and hit the bell button para ma-update kayo sa iba pang videos natin. Alright. Bye-bye.